So I'm here at the Combined Arms Center booth at Association of the United States Army's annual show, and they're showcasing Field Manual 3.0. Now, the paper publication is important. It's got a lot of great material. Been waiting a while for this doctrine. But a new thing they're doing this year is augmented reality. So multi-domain operations is super complex. All kinds of different systems operating from cyber to space, land, sea, air, and they're trying to make a way to visualize that for people using this manual. And we're going to see some augmented reality soon that will showcase how the battle is going to unfold, at least the way the Army thinks it might, with new systems in a multi-domain operations environment.
When you get it, try not to tip it upside down or cover the sensors. Just place it right on your head, and like a bicycle helmet, tighten the knob to the right.
Great. You should see digital hands. I see my digital fingers. Yeah. Well, it's a small bit. Yeah, I see some of it, yeah.
Okay, great.
So what I'm seeing is a human and physical and information domains all in a grid square with maritime. They're color-coded to green and blue. They kind of show the different elements that they're going to have to use, basically just in a concept phase, not really showing materials or tanks or anything yet, just kind of what they're going to have to consider when they're planning these types of operations. On the battlefield, you're seeing the range fans are basically where a particular system can strike immediately. Instantaneously, you can basically hit a button and show where the system's going to strike, how far they're going to reach, and how good their protective bubble is, either from electronic attack or from kinetic attack with, say, air defense or ground defense toward the air. You have deep areas of the enemy kind of outlined in red. You have joint security areas in blue, and kind of a standard linear battle space kind of opening up, but seeing really attacks from all sides, not just a standard march forward, something you would see out of like a Civil War book or manual, or even an old tactics manual. And each of these is overlaid with different types of color-coded bubbles and color-coded arcs showing different types of weapon systems and how they're going to affect enemy forces, how we're going to be affected by those same enemy forces as they strike back or counter-strike.
You can use it for just about anything, and it was not invented or created and primarily intended just to do this. We just found that, hey, here's an opportunity to look at this technology that we might use for other things, like to do rehearsals and a talk. But this is relatively new. I mean, we've only had it for about a year. They put together the programmatics to show these specific things just over the summer. And so I wouldn't call it mature yet, but it's maturing, and it provides a lot of opportunities for the Army to use the tech in other ways. I'll give you an example. When you do rehearsals in the field, you have soldiers that build a big terrain board on the ground. You know, and you've probably seen that before. And you've got icons all over the place. Well, if you had a way to do this, you could do it inside a tent, you could do it in the woods, you can do it anywhere. It's a lot less time consuming, and it actually helps you see more than you could ever create by, you know, moving rocks around or sticking sticks in the ground and all that kind of stuff. So I think that's where the power will be. But to your point about education, you could use this in the classroom. And so instead of using a terrain board for people to work through, hey, this is what a company attack looks or a brigade operation looks like, you could do it on that and potentially start at a higher level of discourse, right? And you're not physically moving things around, but you're actually seeing things happen and they're having explained to you in real time. So there's a lot of potential.
So a lot of ways to visualize things that even in a terrain map might be hard to do, like electronic warfare or cyber things that don't have a visual component necessarily on a stand table, but you can do those maybe with these devices.
Right. And I mean, you know what, people walking around, here's my helicopter, you know, so the air, space, cyberspace domain, but even maritime, if you were in a theater where maritime comes into play, yeah, you can do a lot of things here that you could not do with a terrain map.
What would those poor privates and lieutenants do that don't have to go find MRE boxes and cigarette packs to make the terrain miles?
They'll be pulling security. So that gets to another thing. There's a lot of ideas in this book, right? And one of those ideas is dispersion. You don't want to present yourself as a lucrative target. And we've seen what happened to big fixed command posts on both the Russian and Ukrainian side in the war that's going on right now. So why have to bring everybody to one place where they'd be very vulnerable? You could actually conduct your rehearsals in a distributed fashion. You know, you don't have to do the simulation, everybody standing in one spot. You could actually do it dispersed. And so there's a potential there as well.